So, I think you talked about this already, but first question is what about network latency? Is it relevant here? And how did you overcome the related problems? But I think you already
Yeah, I already covered that. We just did asynchronous replication and ignore latency, basically.
Yeah. So second question is, what about decentralized distributed databases as blockchain approaches? Do you consider it as the extremist replication approach?
I don't think I have a very good answer to that, to be honest. You can, of course, have all kinds of replicated distributed databases, but these are very far away from the offering that we have here.
Okay. Another question is it possible to configure hybrid storage? And it's explained here as in-memory storage and disk storage.
No, in the end, everything is stored on disk, but it depends a little bit. We have, in the database itself, we have two storage engines, a traditional one which is called MM files, for memory mapped files, which is very fast for indexes, but has some limitations in the size of your memory. And nowadays, our preferred storage engine is one that is based on RocksDB, and then you can do a lot more than that, but it's not really in memory only.
Okay. I think I take a last question because I find it interesting myself also to know to hear the answer. So that will be the last one, I promised. So does the replication activity of Arango Sync affect the performance of the main cluster in any way? If not, how did you achieve that?
Well, if I would say it doesn't affect it at all, I would be lying. Because in the end, you need to get data out of it. But it is, we see very little impact on performance. And the reason for that is we are not doing all kinds of fancy queries to get the data out of it. The database already had a replication API where you can say, I'm going to query for every change that happens in this shard. And if there is a change, just tell me. So that is a very efficient way of doing, because as long as nothing changes, you're never being notified and you don't care about anything. And you're not keeping up any resources other than a couple of bytes of storage, perhaps. And only in case when there is actually new data, we fetch the data out. And then it's just a very small request, and since that, especially in our RocksDB storage engine, that's all stored in what's called a WAML file, so that is a very fast accessible file, so the performance overhead is pretty much, I wouldn't say none, but not so much that I care about it at all.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay.
So there were some more questions, but with this we conclude our official group session. So thank you very much for joining Ewout and his talk on the replication of data between data centers. So there's three more activities left in the main hall. You can find them on your card schedule. And if you have individual questions, please feel free to contact Ewout. Okay, yeah. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.